What we see a lot in the market is vendors that acquire third-party AI components that are already pre-trained and integrating them into their platforms. And that is not optimal because those components, those models, might be trained on data that is not specific to talent management. AI at Avature differs from the rest of the market in a very important way. We develop our AI technology in-house from the bottom up. By doing this, we are able to solve the specific problems of our customers. The data that we use at Avature in order to train and optimize our AI models is talent-specific data that we collect ourselves. And because we build our AI technology ourselves from the ground up, then that allows us to integrate it deeply into the rest of the platform. When it comes to AI in the talent management domain, bias is obviously an important concern. At Avature, we take a proactive approach to mitigating bias. And we do that in a couple of ways. One is by not including personal information into the data that the algorithms are trained on. And the other is not to train those algorithms on historical human decisions so that the bias that is hidden in the human decisions does not propagate into the algorithms. The objective of our technology is always to help the user in their decision-making process rather than take the decisions on their behalf. And for that, we take the white box approach to implementing our AI. When we talk about white box, that includes two aspects. One is transparency and the other is control. By transparency, we mean the ability of the user to look behind the reasoning for which the system gives a certain output. And that is important in the support of the decision making because the user now is able to see why is a certain output produced and to validate that output actually. The second aspect of the white box approach is control. And what that means in this context is the user being able to change the relative importance of the attributes that they are doing the matching or they want to produce the recommendation based on. We improve our models continuously in different ways. One very obvious way is to keep training the models on more data, so enlarging the amount of data and also retraining those models on more recent data in order to keep up to date with the reality, basically. We're continuously adding new languages into our AI portfolio, and more are coming down the road. We also keep expanding on the functionality of the recommendations. So for example, we are now building a component in order to support education-based matching and add that capability into the existing recommendation functionality that are based on work experience and skills. Avature is building a chatbot in order to improve the experience of the candidates on the career sites. And that is by providing a way to interact with the system in natural language. In the last year or so, we have seen this amazing explosion of generative AI into the mainstream, and now it's being used in all domains, including talent management. And this technology has amazing potential, but also significant risk, especially in the talent management domain, where this is dealing with decisions that affect humans in a fundamental way. Our strategy at Avature, when it comes to generative AI, is to look at opportunities that have high impact but low risk, while we and the rest of the AI community understand better the potential of this technology.